How's it going, Guardians? Shifty here, and on every Tuesday, I put out a vendor armor and weapon roll video. Last week, I started doing Zerv videos because he now sells legendary armor and weapons. Sometimes those legendary weapons and armor pieces can be worth picking up. So I've decided as long as these videos help somebody out, they're worth making. Now, before I get into the armor and weapon rolls for the week, if you end up enjoying the video, make sure to hit that like button, and if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe as well. Alright, so the first thing anyone wants to know about Xur is where he's located. This week he's in the EDZ and you'll find him in the Winding Cove. And when you finally load in, you're going to be able to find Xur on the top of a cliff in the back of the area. Chances are pretty good that you're going to see some other guardians standing next to him. Alright, so the exotic weapon Xur is selling this week is Telesto. If you don't already have this, I highly recommend picking it up. It's definitely known for breaking the game in multiple ways over the course of Destiny's history. However, if you put all of that aside, it's still a really solid fusion rifle. I've had a lot of fun using this weapon in PvP over the course of Destiny 2. It's always been a solid option in PvE as well. However, this season it's even better with the Unstoppable Fusion Rifle mod as well as Particle Deconstruction. So as I said already, I highly recommend this weapon. Then the Hunter exotic armor this week is the Bombardiers. These just got a buff with Season of the Lost. Now the bomb that you leave behind whenever you dodge has a different effect depending on your subclass. The roll here is actually really solid. You have 23 discipline, which is going to help you get your grenade back faster. You have 12 recovery, and that's important for all three classes because it's tied to how fast you heal. On top of that, this is an exotic that's focused on dodging, and the mobility here is 18. Mobility is tied to the Hunter dodge cooldown. It's nice to have a high stat when it pertains to the ability of the exotic. For Titans this week, you have the Mark 44 Standasides. This basically makes it so that anytime you have a subclass with a shoulder charge ability equipped, and that shoulder charge is charged, while you're sprinting, you'll get an overshield. The stats here are also pretty solid. You have 23 intellect for faster supers, you have 16 recovery for better healing. Unfortunately, it only has 7 strength. Since it's a melee-focused exotic, that is a little bit disappointing. Moving on to the Warlock exotic. This week, Xur is selling Winter's Guile. This is also a melee-focused exotic. Getting melee kills increases melee damage. That can stack up to 5 times. Now, the stats here are also pretty decent. You have 20 recovery, which again is important for healing, but for Warlocks, that is also tied to your Rift cooldown. And as I mentioned, this is a melee-focused exotic. That means the 24 strength is an excellent stat to have on this particular exotic. Now, Winter's Guile doesn't only apply to charged melee abilities, but also your base melee. However, the charged melee abilities are going to definitely benefit the most from Warlord's Sigil. Alright, now let's move on to the legendary weapons that Xur is selling this week. Unfortunately, none of these weapon rolls are particularly great. It seems that every weapon has a mix of good perks and bad perks. However, I can choose a couple of the weapons as honorable mentions. The first one is the Geon 7 rifle. The only reason I'm picking this as an honorable mention is because of the perk synergy. Here you have Grave Robber and Swashbuckler. That means that anytime you get a melee kill, you'll automatically reload this weapon's magazine and get 5 stacks of Swashbuckler for a decent damage bonus. While Swashbuckler is often considered a good perk, many people try to avoid Grave Robber. The other weapon that I think deserves an honorable mention is the Bottom Dollar. Now, this one has Pulse Monitor and Dragonfly. Like I said, most of the weapons are kind of a mixture of bad and good perks. Here, I can say Dragonfly can be pretty fun in some PvE activities. But like I mentioned, Pulse Monitor is not going to be the greatest option of all time. Next up, I want to go over any standout legendary armor for each class. As you can see in the background footage, it seems like Xur wanted to sell garbage to Warlocks this week. None of the armor pieces have any decent stat rolls on them. Sure, you have a few pieces in the 60s, but you don't have any good spiky stat distributions. Now I want to move on to the legendary armor for Titans. Unfortunately, Titans aren't faring much better than Warlocks this week. As you can see here, the stat rolls are actually pretty bad for Titan armor as well. The only exception being the leg armor with 24 intellect, 10 recovery, and 12 resilience. While it's not the best piece of all time, having high intellect can be appealing to some players. And at least this piece has a stat over 20. And lastly, for the Hunter legendary armor, you're pretty much in the exact same boat that Warlocks are. You can see from the footage here, none of the pieces really stand out from the rest. Thankfully for Xur this week, there are a couple of solid exotic armor choices, and he is selling Telesto. I always have to plug Telesto because it is one of my favorite exotic weapons. Anyway, I hope that you enjoyed this week's Xur video, and if you did, remember to like and subscribe. I just want to thank you for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.